In this video, I'm going to show you how you can clean your downloads folder, or any folder for that matter, with a simple Python script. As a bonus, I'm going to show you how you can keep this running so it always keeps your folders clean. Now, to start out, you're going to need Python installed, obviously. So if you haven't done that, check out this video up here. For this mini project, we're going to need two packages from pip. Pystray or Pystray and Watchdog. So let's go ahead and install those and get to coding. So we've now installed Pystray, which we already had, and Watchdog, which we also already have. So for this project, we want to find all the files within a directory, then we want to be able to move the file to another directory, and if there's a file with the same name, we want to be able to rename it first. So first things first, let's figure out how we can find out if a file exists and also loop over all of the files in a given directory. So in order to do that, I'm gonna uncomment this here. So here we're just gonna basically print and we're going to execute this exists function, which comes from os.path where we can import exists. And we're going to pass this f string, which is a pretty cool way of constructing a string using sourcedir, which is this directory here. And this sourcedir directory has a Python PNG and then an image directory, or images directory, which has another Python PNG and a Swift PNG. So when we run this, we're going to check if python.png exists, which it should. And then finally, we're also going to do scandir from OS. So from OS, we're importing scandir. Now scandir is going to basically return an iterator, which you can loop over with the for loop, which allows you to loop over every entry within the directory. And here we're going to print out the entry. Then we're also going to print out, is the entry a directory? And also, is the entry a file? So let's go ahead and run this. Awesome. So the first thing we got here was true because Python is here. It's python.png. Secondly, we got dir of images. It is a directory, which is why this one was true. It was not a file, so that's why this one is false. And then we also got Python for the python.png, false, not a directory, true, it is a file. Amazing. So now we know how to check if a file exists and also loop over every file in a directory. Say like maybe the downloads folder. But wait, listing the files isn't gonna clean them up. Moving them is. So let's code that next. All right, so let's go ahead and show the new code here. So what we have here is an image destination directory, which is what this is. So that's pointing to this images folder. Then we also have a move file function, which we'll go over in a second. And then we have our scandir for loop, which we had from up here, but instead of printing off information about the entry, we're gonna check if the entry is a file. And if it is, we're going to call the move file function here. And we're going to pass the destination as the destination image directory. We're going to pass the source directory where we're calling it from, and also the name of the file we want to move. Now, the first thing that this move file function does is it moves the file, which is important. But one thing that you have to be mindful of is that if you're moving a file, if there's a file with the same name as that file, it could overwrite the file. So we want to kind of handle that case. So in this case, we want to check if a file exists in the destination directory that has the same name as our file. Like for instance, this python.png already exists in our file or in our folder. So what we're going to do is if that exists, we're going to get the file name and the extension from our file's name using split extension, which comes from os.path. Then we're going to set a count of one and loop over basically all of the cases where that file name exists in the directory. And if we find that file, if it does exist, then we're going to basically set the file name to whatever the file name is plus a space and then a bracket, the number that we are using here, and then another bracket with the file extension. So it would be like Python space bracket one bracket dot PNG, for instance. Then all we're gonna do is we're going to rename our file from the old name to the new name and rename it using the rename function, which we are getting from OS. And then once we've done that, we're going to move the file. Pretty simple. So now we can move files from one directory to another directory. And all we need to do is just run our script whenever we want to clean up the directory. Pretty great. But that then means we have to run our script every time we want to clean the directory, which we'll probably forget about, which means it won't stay clean. So let's fix that by watching the directory we care about so that if something changes, it kind of just does it for us. All right, so in order to do that, we don't need this directory scanner anymore, but what we do need is all of this code, which I know looks like a lot, but I promise it's not that bad. So we don't need these because we have these defined, but we're going to basically create an image extension array or list where it's going to have a bunch of the image extensions that you can have, you know, PNGs, JPEGs, things like that. And then we're going to use the watchdog Python module. We're going to use the observer and the file system event handler classes. So we're going to be creating a class for called Watcher. You can name it whatever you'd like, where it's extending the file system event handler class. It's then overriding the onModified function, which this class provides, and it's then going to call self.clean. When it calls self.clean, it's going to basically do what we just did before, where we're going to loop over everything within our source directory, find the entries. If it's a directory, we're going to continue, basically skipping this loop. And then for each extension within the image extension list, if the extension matches the end of whatever the file name is, like PNG, then we're going to try and move the file. Now, how does Watcher work? Well, all we're doing here is just instantiating a Watcher instance. Then we're instantiating an observer instance from the watchdog library. And then we're going to call observer.schedule, and we're going to pass in our file system event handler class, which is Watcher in this case, then the directory we want to watch. And then recursive basically just means that it's going to loop over everything within the directories. Finally, we are going to start our observer. So this thing is going to start watching the directory. And then we're going to sleep for 20 seconds. Now, if you've ever used sleep in Python, you might be wondering, how does that not just stop everything? Because usually it stops your program. Well, observer.start actually causes the observer to run in a background thread. If you want to learn more about how threading works, leave a comment down below and I'll make a video on that, because it could kind of be its own video itself. But basically, it's just going to run in the background. Then once sleep is finished, we're going to then stop the observer thread and then join blocks on the main thread and ensures that the background thread is all finished and cleaned up. So let's go ahead and check out if this works. So we're going to go ahead and run this. And when we run this, if I go to this directory, let me just get rid of that. And if I copy this, go over here and paste this in, we can see that when I paste it, it went back into this directory. If I do the same with Swift, also went into the directory. Just in time, because the sleep ended. So we could just run this in a while loop so this runs forever, but that would mean that we'd still just need to execute it from the command line. So instead, let's make it into an exe so we can just double click it, or even better, just have it run when our computer starts. But one of the issues with that is that if you want to interact with it, you don't really have any way of doing so. So let's use Pystray so that we can make a little system tray that we can use to interact with our program. All right, so now we can just delete all of these lines here to use Pystray or Pystray. So the first thing we're going to do here is create an image using image from PIL, which just comes for free with Python. Then we're going to create a stop function, which I'll go over in a second. And then we're going to use icon. Now from Pystray, we're importing icon as icon, menu as menu, and menu item as item. Now what we have here is we are using icon. We're passing in the name of computer cleaner. Then we are setting the icon to be the image that we just made, our 64 by 64 red block. And then we're going to set our menu to be an item where it has the single menu item of exit, and that's going to call stop. Now, when you do this, stop is actually going to provide an icon reference to the icon we have here. Now that's important because you can't actually stop the Pystray instance unless you have a reference to it. So this is kind of important. So basically when we click exit, it will stop the observer. It will make sure that the observer has cleaned itself up, has finished and cleaned up its background thread, and then it will stop the icon. Basically stopping the tray so that it's allowed to stop the program. All right, amazing. So all we have to do now is just comment out these three things here. Otherwise, it's not going to work very well. And let's go ahead and test this. So if we execute our thing here, we can see that we have a little block down here. I have a lot of other things over. And if we go over to here and start pasting in some Python files, it's working. That's perfect. We have so many Pythons. Never too much Python, right? All right, so this is perfect. It's working great. And now if we want to stop our program, we can go ahead and right click and click exit. Amazing. All right, time to executableify the script. So in order to do this, we want to install autopy to exe and go ahead and get that installed. And then we'll do autopy to exe. That will open up this little window here and we can browse to our file, which is just this right here. And we want it to be a window-based file, basically meaning that a console will not pop up. And we can go ahead and click convert.py to .exe. All right, that's all done. So if we go ahead and open this folder and go into here and scroll down, we can see we have this cleaner. And if we double click this, we can see that it runs and it has started our cleaner. We can go ahead and exit that. Now we just need to add the exe to our startup directory. To do that, you can just press Windows key R and then within this type shell colon startup, that will open up this startup directory. And then we can go ahead and right click and click create shortcut and then just move this shortcut right over to the startup directory. And now when you restart your computer, it'll start the cleaner automatically. Thanks to RedHat1230 for the suggestion on using the startup folder and also Pystray from this video on how we can control your computer with Python. Now we have a program that's just gonna run in the background anytime we start up our computer and clean up folders for us. That's it. You can now create a script to automate all of the folders on your computer. So your computer will be cleaner than your desk. Hopefully. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, please drop a like down below and consider subscribing for more videos like this in the future. We also have a Discord now. If you want to join that, link to that is in the description. And if you have any suggestions on what you'd like to see in the future, maybe drop a comment for that. Remember, I'm Jake, you're awesome, and this has been Cleaning Your Computer with Python. Cheers. Now I've got to clean my desk.